Good morning and Merry Christmas. Welcome to Wicker Park Lutheran Church. We are delighted to be worshiping with you here today. And please know that wherever you are on your spiritual or religious journey, you are welcome here in this place. Today, we are very excited to be worshiping with all of the congregations in the Metropolitan Chicago Synod as we engage in a service of lessons and carols. Today, I would encourage you to use our electronic bulletin, which you can find using the link on your screen, or using the QR code, which you're just going to take out your smartphone, and you're going to scan that QR code with your camera. Now, not all of the hymns or the readings will be on the screen, so that will be very helpful for today's worship. Now, I invite you to make a sacred space around you. That might mean lighting some candles. That might mean putting away distractions. As we gather together with all of the congregations across the synod, and we worship this morning.
Beloved, rejoice and sing. Christ is born in Bethlehem and dwells among us in the Metropolitan Chicago Synod. Amid injustice and poverty, we see the justice and abundance of God through Him. We come to the Christ child, rejoicing in this amazing gift of grace, singing to God songs of hope, peace, joy, and love around the world.
Oh, come.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
El Señor esté con ustedes.
¿Y también contigo?
Oremos. Dios misericordioso, viniste a estar entre nosotros, compartiendo nuestra humanidad como un bebé. Ábrenos para llenarnos de la maravilla y el gozo de la presencia de Jesús en el mundo. Y abre nuestra boca para compartir las buenas nuevas, para que todos y todas las escuchen. Que Jesús, nuestro Salvador, ha nacido. Let us pray. Gracious God, you came to be among us, sharing our humanity as a baby. Open us up to be filled with the wonders and joys of Jesus' presence in the world. And open our mouths to share the good news for all to hear that Jesus, our Savior, is born. Amen.
In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness God called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and for years, and let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth." And it was so. God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good.
Each winter, as the year grows older, we each grow older too. The chill sets in a little colder. The verities we knew seem shaken and untrue. When race and class cry out for treason, when sirens scream for war, they overshout the voice of reason and scream till we ignore all we've held dear before. Yet I believe beyond believing that life can spring from death, that growth can flower from our grieving, that we can catch our breath and turn transfixed by faith. So even as the sun is turning to journey to the north, the living flame in secret burning can kindle on the earth and bring God's love to birth. O child of ecstasy and sorrow, O prince of peace and pain, brighten today's world by tomorrow's, renew our lives again, Lord Jesus, come and reign.
A reading from Micah, the 5th chapter. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace.
Christ, whose glory fills the skies, Christ the everlasting light, the Son of righteousness, arise and triumph o'er these shades of night. Come now long awaited one, in the fullness of your love, and loose this heart bound up by shame, and I will
for the very first time, I just want to extend a special welcome. And I also want to draw your attention to our digital Connect card, which is available using the link on the screen. And again, you can also use your phone or a smart device so that you might scan that QR code. And on that digital Connect card, we'd love for you to check off that you're visiting with us for the first time. And I'm going to reach out to you just invite you to grab a drink. Of course, in this socially distant time, it will probably have to be over Zoom or the phone, but we're going to send you a gift card so that you can get a chance to buy a coffee on us as we then get a chance to chat and I get to learn a little bit more about you and you can hear a bit more about how you might get connected with our many ministries here. Also on that digital Connect card, though, you can express some of your interest in those digital ministries. Things like maybe helping to serve the night ministry, where we serve 75 hungry bellies in the Pilsen neighborhood on the second Thursday of every month. Or maybe you want to be a volunteer to help stock our free pantry right here outside the church. Or you want to get involved with book club. Or you want to learn more about our digital Sunday school ministries, our live events that we have once a month. That and so many more things you can do with that digital Connect card right there on the screen. And so even if you are not a first-time visitor, you can use that digital Connect card for all of those things and giving a prayer request or indicating that you're interested in becoming a member or that you're interested in baptism. We have a special story from the Congregation Council, and so I would invite you to take a moment to hear that story.
Once upon a time, there were two villagers who were forced by the city to pay lots of money for water running through lead pipes. Yuck! Then, one day, as the villagers cried about their bills, a bird flew by and dropped 126,000 seeds. These seeds went deep into the ground and began growing. At first, the villagers didn't notice anything, But as the seeds began to grow, the ground opened and tore up their landscaping. All of a sudden, the pipe, deep underground, was transformed, and the villagers noticed clear water and a much smaller water bill. The villagers were in awe. A short time later, before their very eyes, the ground began to flatten and sprung forth with native plants, seat benches, and places to gather outside. In a socially distanced manner, of course. Those two villagers were amazed and began skipping with tears of joy. They were so humbled by the experience that they called this hallowed ground the Wicker Park Gathering Garden. But the story doesn't end there, because you can take flight and drop the seeds to make this grow. So fly on over to www.wickerparklutheran.org/garden to learn more. You can drop us a few seeds now as a tax-deductible gift, or let us know seeds are on their way in up to 2 installments given on or before February 15th and August 15th, 2021. Let us know before January 17th so the villagers can be on the lookout. Just think. Together, we can be the seeds that transform this little village.
Now, all of that might sound just like a cute story, but there are actual factual details that you can get on the website. In just a moment, I invite you to either reflect on the gifts that you've already given or to give electronically using the links on the screen, either Venmo or PayPal or through our giving website.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let all their songs employ, what fields and floods, what tears and plains. Repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. No more let sin and sorrow grow, nor thorns infest the ground. He comes to make His blessings flow. For as the curse is found, for as the curse is found, for as the curse is found. Here rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of His righteousness, and wonders of His love, and wonders of His love, and wonders, wonders of His love.
Hello. Today's reading comes from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verses 26 through 35 and 38.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his word and pondered what sort of greetings this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end."
Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. Then Mary said, Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your servant. Then the angel departed from her.
Good news of great joy for every woman, every man. This will be a sign to you, a baby born in Bethlehem. Come and worship, do not be afraid. A company of angels, glory in the highest, and on the earth a peace among those on whom his favor rests. Come and worship, do not be afraid. My soul, magnifies the Lord, my soul. Magnifies the Lord. He has done great things for me, great things for me. Unto you a child is born, unto us a son is given. Let every heart prepare his throne. Let every nation under heaven come and worship. Do not be afraid. My soul, magnifies the Lord. My soul, magnifies the Lord. Done great things for me, great things for me. My soul, magnifies the Lord. My soul, magnifies the Lord. He has done great things for me, great things for me. Of his government there will be no end. He'll establish it with his righteousness, and he shall reign on David's throne, and his name shall be from this day on wonderful counselor, everlasting
the Lord. My soul, magnifies.
He has done great things for us. He has done great things for us. He has done great things for us. He has done great things for us.
Magnifies.
magnifies the Lord. My soul, magnifies the Lord. Lord, He has done great things for me, great things for me.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, for there was no room for them at the inn.
Well, all is well, Evangelio San Lucas, capítulo 2, versos 8 al 16. En esa misma región había unos pastores que pasaban la noche en el campo, turnándose para cuidar sus rebaños. Sucedió que un ángel del Señor se le apareció. La gloria del Señor los envolvió en su luz y se llenaron de temor. Pero el ángel les dijo: no tengan miedo, miren que les traigo buenas noticias, que será motivo de mucha alegría para todo el pueblo. Hoy le ha nacido en la ciudad de David un Salvador, que es Cristo el Señor. Esto les servirá de señal. Encontrarán un niño envuelto en pañales y acostado en un pesebre. De repente apareció una multitud de ángeles del cielo que alababan a Dios y decían: gloria a Dios en las alturas y en la tierra paz a los que gozan de su buena voluntad. Cuando los ángeles se fueron al cielo, los pastores se dijeron unos a otros: vamos a Belén a ver esto que ha pasado y que el Señor nos ha dado a conocer. Así que fueron de prisa y encontraron a María y a José y al niño que estaba acostado en el pesebre. Palabra de Dios.
A reading from Mark. After 8 days had passed, it was time to circumcise the child, and he was called Jesus, the name given by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. When the time came for their purification according to the law of Moses, they brought him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male shall be designated as holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all people, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people, Israel. And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother, Mary, this child is destined for the falling and for the rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too. And there was also a prophet Anna, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was of great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage. Thanks be to God.
Jesus, Jesus, oh, what a wonderful child. Jesus, Jesus, so lowly, meek and mild. New life, new hope, new joy he brings. We gotta listen to the angels singing. Glory, glory, glory to the newborn King. Jesus, Jesus, oh, what a wonderful child. Jesus, Jesus, so lowly, meek and mild. New life, new hope, new joy he brings. We gotta listen to the angels singing. Glory, glory, glory to the newborn King. He was heralded by the angels, born in a lonely manger. The Virgin Mary was his mother, and Joseph was his earthly father. Oh, three wise men came from afar. They were guided by the shining star to see King Jesus where he laid in a manger filled with hay. Jesus, Jesus, oh, what a wonderful child. Jesus, my little Jesus, so lowly, meek and mild. New life, new hope, new joy he brings. We gotta listen to the angels singing. Glory, glory, glory to the newborn King. Oh, Jesus, my little Jesus. Oh, what a wonderful child, talking about Jesus, my little Jesus, so lowly, meek and mild. New life, new hope, new joy he brings. We gotta listen to the angels singing. Glory, glory, glory to the newborn King. Glory, glory, glory to the newborn King. Oh, what a wonderful child.
Lectura según San Mateo. Jesús nació en Belén, un pueblo de la región de Judea, en el tiempo en que Herodes era rey del país. Llegaron por entonces a Jerusalén unos sabios del Oriente que se dedicaban al estudio de las estrellas y preguntaron: ¿dónde está el rey de los judíos que ha nacido? Pues vimos salir su estrella y hemos venido a adorarlo. El rey Herodes inquietó mucho al oír esto, y lo mismo les pasó a los habitantes de Jerusalén. Mandó el rey llamar a todos los jefes de los sacerdotes y a los maestros de la ley, y les preguntó dónde había de nacer el Mesías. Ellos le dijeron, en Belén de Judea, porque así lo escribió el profeta. En cuanto a ti, Belén, de la tierra de Judá, no eres la más pequeña entre las principales ciudades de esa tierra, porque de ti saldrá un gobernante que guiará a mi pueblo Israel. Entonces Herodes llamó en secreto a los sabios y se informó por ellos del tiempo exacto en que había aparecido la estrella. Luego los mandó a Belén y les dijo, «Vayan allá y averigüen todo lo que puedan acerca de ese niño, y cuando lo encuentren, avísenme, para que yo también vaya a rendirle homenaje». Con esas indicaciones del rey, los sabios se fueron, y la estrella que habían visto salir iba delante de ellos, hasta que por fin se detuvo sobre el lugar donde estaba el niño. Cuando los sabios vieron la estrella, se alegraron mucho. Luego entraron en la casa y vieron al niño con María, su madre, y arrodillándose le rindieron homenaje. Abrieron sus cofres y le ofrecieron oro, incienso y mirra. Palabra de Dios. Te alabamos, Señor.
Ese tu candor, el alma me roba, el amor. Niño lindo, ante ti me rindo, niño lindo, eres tú mi Dios. Niño lindo, ante ti me rindo, niño lindo, eres tú mi Dios. La vida bien mío y el alma también, te ofrezco gustoso, rendido a tus pies. Niño lindo, ante ti me rindo, niño lindo, eres tú mi Dios. Niño lindo, ante ti me rindo, niño lindo. Adiós dulce amante, adiós dulce amante, adiós niño, adiós. Niño lindo, ante ti me rindo, niño lindo, eres tú mi Dios. Niño lindo, ante ti me rindo, niño lindo, eres tú mi Dios.
Lectura según San Mateo, capítulo 2, versos del 13 al 18. La huida a Egipto. Cuando ya se había ido, un ángel del Señor se le apareció en sueños a José y le dijo, «Levántate, toma al niño y a su madre, y huye a Egipto. Quédate allí hasta que yo te avise, porque Herodes va a buscar al niño para matarlo». Así que se levantó cuando todavía era de noche. Tomó al niño y a su madre y partió para Egipto, donde permaneció hasta la muerte de Herodes. De este modo se cumplió lo que el Señor había dicho por medio del profeta: de Egipto llamé a mi hijo. Cuando Herodes se dio cuenta de que los sabios se habían burlado de él, se enfureció y mandó matar a todos los niños menores de 2 años en Belén y en sus alrededores, de acuerdo con el tiempo que había averiguado de los sabios. Entonces se cumplió lo dicho por el profeta Jeremías: se oye un grito en Ramá, llanto y gran lamentación. Es Raquel, que llora por sus hijos y no quiere ser consolada. Sus hijos ya no existen. Palabra del Señor.
Lectura del Evangelio de San Juan, capítulo 1, versículos del 1 al 14. El Verbo se hizo carne. En el principio ya existía el Verbo, y el Verbo estaba con Dios. Y el Verbo era Dios. Él estaba con Dios en el principio. Por medio de Él, todas las cosas fueron creadas. Sin Él, nada de lo creado llegó a existir. En Él estaba la vida, y la vida era la luz de la humanidad. Esta luz resplandece en las tinieblas, y las tinieblas no han podido extinguirla. Vino un hombre llamado Juan. Dios lo envió como testigo para dar testimonio de la luz, a fin de que por medio de él todos creyeran. Juan no era la luz, sino que vino para dar testimonio de la luz. Esa luz verdadera, la que alumbra a todo ser humano, venía a este mundo. El que era la luz ya estaba en el mundo, y el mundo fue creado por medio de él, pero el mundo no le reconoció. Vino a lo que era suyo, pero los suyos no le recibieron. Mas a cuantos lo hicieron, a los que creen en su nombre, les dio el derecho de ser hijos de Dios. Estos no nacen de la sangre, ni por deseos naturales, ni por voluntad humana, sino que nacen de Dios. Y el Verbo se hizo hombre y habitó entre nosotros, y hemos contemplado su gloria, la gloria que corresponde al Hijo unigénito del Padre, lleno de gracia y de verdad. Esta es palabra de Dios.
Reunidos en un cuerpo por medio del Espíritu Santo, oremos el Padre nuestro usando el lenguaje de nuestro corazón. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, we pray the Lord's Prayer using the language of our heart. Padre nuestro, que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre. Venga tu reino. Hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día. Perdona nuestras ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en tentación y líbranos del mal. Porque tuyo es el reino, tuyo es el poder y tuya es la gloria, ahora y siempre. Amén. Dios Todopoderoso, quien envió el Espíritu Santo a María, proclamó gozo a través de los ángeles, envió a los pastores con buenas noticias y guió a los magos por medio de una estrella, te bendiga en este día mediante el Verbo hecho carne. Amén. Almighty God, who sent the Holy Spirit to Mary, proclaim joy through the angels. Send the shepherds with good news and let the Magi by the star bless you this day through the word made flesh. Amen. Ve en paz, comparte el don de Jesús.
Demos gracias a Dios.
Go in peace, share the gift of Jesus.
Thanks be to God.
Compartan un signo de paz de Dios los unos con los otros y ¡Feliz Navidad! Share a sign of God's peace with one another and Merry Christmas.
Tell it on a mountain, over the hills and everywhere.
Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere.
Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere.
Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.